two extreme friends. One was, he was studying a lot. Both of them, one of studying a lot, and they are getting, one is getting good in the exam, and another one we find, though he studied a lot, his grade was not up to the mark. So it was a long question to me actually why this happened. Then, when I am working on this presentation, I heard about a theory and I studied about it, and now I think I am getting some answer of this question. So today I am going to present, this is, I think it was, okay, so this is a Pareto principle, the 80-20. This is, what is Pareto principle and what about this? So I organized the presentation like about Pareto and the principle. I will say something about it and examples of Pareto principles, benefits of using Pareto principle in your everyday life and different organization using. Some reminder in our daily life, what reminds us these Pareto principles and how we can remind ourselves. And at the end, the conclusion, and I have some reference I will show. So what is about Pareto principle? Pareto is an Italian engineer, sociologist, economist, political scientist, and philosopher. So he discovered the Pareto principles. Pareto principle is specifies an unequal relationship between input and output. Actually, what is the how much input we are giving, and what is the output we are getting? So he has observed that there are some unequal relationship. The principle state directly, if I say that in many situations, 20% of the invested input is responsible for 80% of the result. Okay, so that means he was giving some examples. So he was doing a research on economics in Italy, household survey, and he personally found that richest 20% of the world's population control 87% of the world income while he was reviewing the literature. Then he was digging into that, actually why it's happening, why it is happening. Then we have seen there more about the principle. It's found that 80% of sales will come from 20% of the 20% of sales people. Again, 80% of results come from 20% of effort. And this size is also observing that we can see few cities, many villages, few large fields, wild fields we see, few large fields, small fields, more small fields. And so after that, actually many researchers dig into that and found that it's a miracle, you know. It's almost in our everyday life, everywhere it's taking place, it's happening. So we have seen that Microsoft, we have found that Microsoft noted by fixing the top 20% of most reported bugs, 80% error can be solved. So, and you know, the 50% of time we spend with our 20% of friends, if we see ourselves, we think back ourselves. And again, like we always see that 20% of the favorite dress in 80% of time we use. So then, different research, actually different organization did. So I am showing here some benefits of the Pareto principle. They found three benefits you can get. Create more balance for what getting too much or too little of your time and attention. We can actually see, we can analyze this and to make a balance that actually, why should I give more emphasis and why I not, where I'm getting better result and where I'm getting more emphasis. Become more efficient. You do more of what works, less what doesn't work. So you can do actually what is giving more result, we should give more emphasis on that. And what is giving less result, we should give less emphasis on that. And more effective, if you can identify which efforts get best result, you can apply your time and focus far more effectively. And we have seen that Roberts remind us that 80-20 principle remind us to focus on 20% that matters. Which 20% actually that matters for my life, for my everyday, for my business, for my education. If something in the schedule has to slip, make sure that it's not part of that 20%. So if we have to skip something, so we'll have to be careful that we are not skipping which is contributing for our 80% of the result. Doesn't just work smart. Work smart on the right things actually. And in conclusion, actually you have seen that many personal organizations, they made success in their life and in their business using these Plato's principles. And another thing is that in fact the Plato principle doesn't demand that IT ratio applies in every situation. So we'll have to think about this also. And the examples used here is not statistic effect, but based on observation and experience, we see that it's happening. So, and there's some references from where I have got this information. So that's all.